All right, let's get started. First thing I want to do is create a roof. And let's start out with basic shape here. Hope everybody's doing well. This is Dan Hacks. I'm going to be working on a brand new house here today. It's going to be a modern Oriental, preferably Korean style home for me and my partner. And I really need to devise a roof, something I can top the building off with. So that's what we're going to work on here. Oops. Let's see. Let's go ahead and open that up. We zoom out. I'm going to go ahead and expand that to the length and size I need. I'm going to go with 50 meters. By 50 meters. This is all going to be condensed and cut away, so let's see. We'll start out with making a hole in the center, and now we need to cut this into pieces to give it the proper angle. We'll start with 0.75, and we're going to rotate that. Actually, let's look at this. Sorry, I'm thinking out loud. But then again, you're listening, right? So that may be a good thing. I always work with a white texture. It just makes it easier for me to, it's like a blank canvas. Makes it that much easier to actually see what I want to build. So we'll expand that way. And now I want to I'm gonna duplicate that. Rotate it 180 degrees. It doesn't really matter if they connect perfectly because I need to add trims there. But, I do want to group both of these, and I may actually mesh this together once I'm done here. We'll see. Actually, let me ungroup it for now. I need to reduce the size on that. Seems to be a different angle, something more like that. Let's see. Make this 20. I'm gonna make that one 20. That's more like it. Go ahead and group this now. And right there in the middle of it, I'm gonna go ahead and paint one of these red so I can tell where the center of it is. Right there in the middle of it, first thing I'm going to do is move this to the center of the sim. Same thing with that one. Should not have done it that well. Let's try it again. 128. Be a pain in my ass, whatever. Killer. Like I say, I never grouped it. Well, that's a bit of a problem, man. Let's group it. There we go. Alright, now let's move it. I'm a little distracted at the moment. I'm also playing a game on my iPad here. So just a little distracted. But we'll be good. We'll be good here. All right, that's actually sitting in the center of the sim now. And what I want to do now is actually put a bar in the middle of it. So I might as well go ahead and replicate this. And we're going to rotate that 90 degrees this way. And now you see the shape that I'm giving it, right? Let me go ahead and group all this together. And this is actually going to be flipped. Again, 180 degrees this way. I need to decide if that's really the position I want. And I think it needs to be a little bit different. I actually bought one, and I'm going to mimic this. This is what I bought. Now, it was not textured. I had to texture it myself. But it is my own print. So it was a sculpt map. And I actually think it's kind of decent, but I'm thinking I may want to make my own. So what I need to do here now, I see based on the one that I purchased, is I need to actually make these quarters and not halves. So I need to try that again. I need to set up my my draw distance a bit so I can actually see both items at the same time. And yes, I still have some waterfall sitting here on the center. So yeah, if I were to take this apart, let me see. There's one, there's two, there's three, and they are quarter pikes. So let's go ahead and make that. So this needs to be cut in half again. So first things first, let's make it all one color so I can actually see what the hell I'm doing. And now, I'm a little confused. The quarter pikes on that angle. I see. These need to be sliced in half. Nope. For those of you that have ever used the numeric system to build, sometimes this can get really confusing for me. I don't know why. Let me test it. Yeah, that may actually be it. Sometimes it's just really confusing. Now see, that gives me the half, but I'm not sure it's the right half. I think there's a little problem, a little difficulty here discerning what shape I need that to be. I think that's correct, but this may actually be wrong. Nope, that was correct. I think it's my angle is wrong, huh? This is the part I hate. It's like guesswork, and after a while it really gets cumbersome. So see, that's not right either. I'm gonna go ahead and unlink all this, or start over. I see, now I understand where my problem was. Boy, that was really a stupid thing to do. The pieces are correct, they're just not in the right angle. And the other thing is, let's see, so this actually needs to come over here. There it is. Silly me. I'll go ahead and put that right there. Now we can link it together. Much better. Let's move it back to the center. So basically that's the correct shape. Do one center. There we go. Now that angle there in the corners. Let's see. I actually like mine better. I like it with that angle there. It gives me a place to stick columns. Actually much nicer. Now let me try to go ahead and tile this. And by tile it, I mean texture it. Let's see what that looks like. The reason I'm making my own is because of the faces. This is all, this is a decent looking roof. I could clearly use this. Again, picture it without the texture. That's what it looked like. It's just, and basically that's what I'm looking for. So the problem is the faces, those of you that understand what I'm talking about, there's only one face there, and here basically I created three faces as I need. Let's go ahead and tile this. I want to see something. The other thing is with plain art, because I'm making it using my own printer, I may actually be able to use plain art. You see, when you do that, it does distort the tile. So we're not doing that. We'll keep it this way. I'm going to do 11, let's say 77. Mm-hmm. Way too much. Alright. So that looks better. So that's kind of nice. And I already like this better than the one I bought. So let's go ahead and I'm gonna add some detail to it now. Let's see. I'm gonna remove this one. Send it back to my inventory. Let's concentrate on this. And I'm gonna go ahead and add some detail to it. There really is, it's not where I need it to be, so I'm gonna actually move it to where I want it to be, 128 by 128. It should be the center of the sun, but the land is apparently not properly parsed at the moment. All right, so at the moment, what I wanna do here is do that. Why did I make this? Okay. We'll make that one 63. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and thicken that up a bit. I like chunky trims, makes it easier to work, but I think it also looks more masculine when you piece it all together. And let's go ahead and duplicate that part. Now I can actually take it down a little bit, bring that down to 1.5. And do the same thing with this one. It's not too bad. Make sure that the ends there are basically identical. They are. Now, the other thing I'd like to do is, I was looking at photos earlier. I'm not going to switch over because I am recording the screen. But I was looking at photographs of what Oriental roofs look like, specifically Korean roofs. And there are a couple of different styles. This is fairly decent. I will have to top that off at the bottom, though. Not a problem. So let's go ahead and, normally I don't texture things till after I'm done, but I'd like to get a feel for what this is going to look like. I think I'm going to make that gold, like a golden texture, so let me look for that. If not gold, then maybe a nice heavy wood color. There's a certain color scheme that I want to maintain, and I happen to love that dark roof tile. However, it's not really in the right shade, and I may have to redo that texture to get it to look appropriate. Maybe not. That's better. Much better. Already looking better. And instead of this wood here, I'm going to create or try something else. Much better. I happen to love this texture. I use it quite a bit. And it's funny, it never gets old. And see, that's kind of in the right color range. Now, let me see, maybe, just maybe, I don't really want to do that. I was going to slice these into halves, but there's really no point in doing that. Let's go ahead and clean up the edges here, again. And I think I will go ahead and mesh this, although I think if I mesh it, at the moment it's only like 6 frames, land impact. If I mesh it, it may actually be much higher than land impact. So, I'm debating whether or not I want to do that. At the ends there. It's only one by one now. And I'm going to rotate that so it matches the rest of the wood grain on the top. There we go. Make sure it's centered. I don't think it is. It's just a little bit off. Let's bring this down using the numeric tab. And sometimes, for those of you that build, I don't know if you're aware of it, but if you're using Firestone, just use the lighting and bring the lighting to where you want it to be, and that you can get a better perspective of lighting. It also, it may help to turn off shadows in the graphic preferences if you're actually going to be working, just to avoid the shadows. But I personally like working with shadows. I'll just move the lighting around as needed. That way I can also bring up the lighting and get a better idea of what I'm working on. Alright, so let's see. This one here seems to be okay. I'm going to go ahead and redo that. Move that one aside. And I'm going to replicate that one since I know that one's correct. Now that one should be correct too. Alright, those two are linked together. We'll get rid of this old one. And now you can see that the roof is starting to take shape. Now, I'd like to add some detail to it. And then, of course, we'll see what it looks like when I mesh it out. To mesh it out, I'll have to do a couple of different things to it. Alright, so let's find the center of this. And so far, it's there. I'm going to go ahead and write down the center of that. It says 128 by 128, but frankly, let me see something. If I empty out the sim, the water. And it's not really the center of the sim, is it? Not even close. Alright, we'll worry about that later. Let's see, for now, the coloring is wrong, but that's okay, because we'll have to retexture this later once it's meshed out. I want to work on detail. Now, in the center here, which will probably become my prime trim, I'd like to take the measurements there. And we'll put, I'm going to decide what shape I want. I saw something earlier today in a one of the photos that I was looking at. I like to do a little bit of research, by the way, that's me. I like to do a little research when I start a new project, depending on the style that I'm going to be using. And in my research, I saw a couple of different designs for roofs. And one had something similar to this. This shape here in the center. That that would become wood as well, I imagine. Now, that's not nearly ornate enough. So maybe top that off with a little ball at the top or something. Go ahead and change my light again and get a better perspective of what I'm doing. Let me piece that together and make this the return step. The ball on the top. I'm going to go ahead and pick up that same texture, same color. Change my lighting to accommodate my needs. The music in the background that I'm playing is Manila Killa. You'll find them on SoundCloud. And I just happen to love this mix. So it goes on for like an hour. And just really beautiful music. Manila Killa, gotta love the name as well. All right, so we've got our centerpiece there. Now, I'm thinking it may not actually be ornate enough. So I'm gonna go ahead and separate this again.
Don't leave me.
Now I'm gonna go ahead and grab this cone. I'm gonna slice that cone. Let's see if I can do this. It's been a while since I've used these numbers to build here. Let's see. I'm gonna cut that. Let's try something else. That's not it. This is not what I want, but I'll give it a try. Of course, that won't work. Great song. God, such a great song. Now, let's keep that the way it is, but I do want to change this a bit. Here, I can find it right. No, it's not too bad, but actually that may work. I could only taper it the other way. It'd be nice if this worked more like a actual 3D modeling program. You just grab these corners and pull them in. That would actually be very, very helpful. Maybe one day the Lindens will actually update their building tools here. It would be nice considering I've been here 14 years and really nothing has changed. Nothing has changed in all that time. But, well, we make do with what we have, right? I'm debating what I want to do here. I do actually want to bring this in so I can get the tops to go in. Let's see, taper? Yeah. There we go. That's more like it. Great. I'm going to go ahead and remove that one. I'm going to go ahead and duplicate that one. Excuse me. I've had a bit of a cold for a while now, and still hacking up some pretty nasty stuff. I won't get into any details on where else, Barry. We're rotating these at a 15 degree angle. I'm gonna make four of them, five of them. One more. Not really sure I like that. Maybe a bit much. Let's ungroup these. Remove every other one and give it a try. And I'm not really sure about the angle either. So let's give that a shot. This is a part of the experimental build part. It's something that needs to be done on a regular basis as well. Maybe I'm just talking nonsense. I'm really sure like this. Not really sure I like it. And it may just be overkill. Maybe that's all I really need. And then, if I actually taper this down a bit more. It's actually better. A little more of a steep angle there on the sides. It's a little better. Go ahead and give that a shot. Now, I'm going to create something. I want it to be, I'm not really sure what I'm looking for, but I guess I'll know it when I see it. I want it to be modern, a little abstract, I suppose, and yet traditional Oriental, so I'm thinking maybe something like that, like this 0.7, 0.7. That's not too bad. I'm going to take this ball 45 degrees. Just a little texture. Obviously I can rotate just the texture, but do it that way. Alright, I'm kind of happy with it. It's not all that great. There's nothing to write home about. It works. I'll go ahead and piece all this together. Make sure it's grouped. Again, make sure it's grouped. That's going to become our prime trim, that ball at the top. Now I need to decide what I want to do with this bottom piece. I know one thing for sure. I need to copy that number there. I'm going to go ahead and create another trim. It'll actually be easier just to grab the ball. I thought of that before I group it all together. We'll go ahead and ungroup the ball. Duplicate of that ball. And turn that ball into a box. And if I recall correctly, the dimensions here was 63. I'm gonna make that 63 by 63. This is gonna become the bottom. Position to the right place. Again, may want to flush with that piece right there. Something like that. You know, I happen to like my roof a hell of a lot more than the one I bought. And by the way, the one I bought was 10 lumens, so no big deal. It was good, good reference to use to make my own. Now, I may want to add more detail here. Again, I'm going to mesh this out and see what the land impact is. Maybe too high, in which case I'll just use this version. But I always try to minimize the amount of fringe or land impact used on the center. It's not too bad. We'll go ahead and give that the same texture and color. That is, no matter no matter how I rotate the texture, it's not going to match one of the sides. So really at that point, you should do a 45 degree, probably like that, minus 45, something like that, so it meets the corners. That's not too bad. And if I really wanted it to match, I could do it, but I'd have to use more trims. If I do mesh it out, it won't make a difference, but if I don't, then yeah, I'm just adding to the trim cost here. I'm just going to keep it simple for now. I don't think anybody will even notice that. I'm basically ready to grab the whole thing, but I think maybe, just maybe, I'd like to add some more detail. So I'm going to do this. Just the one. Okay. Group it with that one. That one's smaller. Maybe a little bit smaller. Something like that. Not really liking that, but I've got a feeling I'm about to change it a bit. What I wanted to do was change the thickness of the pieces, not necessarily the length. So I'm going to make these the same length as that one. 63. And now what I'm actually going to do is take each one, let's see this top one here, just come down a little bit. Now whenever you see the textures overlap like that, because there are two frames overlapping each other, that will actually create lag on the simulator. So whenever possible, avoid that. And the easiest way to avoid that is just grab each one, the one you want to change a little bit. Just minimize that by, say, something like that. That's not what I wanted. Let's try again. I'm gonna cut back a little bit. You can see there, just a little bit. And do the same thing with the top one there. So we'll make this 62.5. Once I do that, 62.97. So that one there needs to be 62.95. There we go. So stagger it like that just a little bit. You can do it even less than that. The idea is to not let the edges there overlap, because that will in fact create lag. I'm gonna go ahead and copy that number. Give it to this trim right there. And then same thing with this number. And put that number on that trim over there. Now everything should be staggered just a little bit. And apparently I selected the wrong one. There we go. Alright, so that's good to go. Now we could actually put something else there on each of these ends as well, just to add a little more detail. Not sure it's really necessary. That actually looks halfway decent. I hope you agree. But yeah, I'm happy with that. So there we go. That's my roof structure that I'm thinking of using for the main house. And of course, I'll be able to shrink it down as needed. Although the maximum size is 64 and I'm at 63 now, so that's pretty much the maximum size I can make this particular roof. Yeah, it looks halfway decent. Now, do I want it open there in the ends? Maybe not. That's something else to contemplate. So, let's see, the shape. And the shape may be a little complex to make, those edges there, but I'm gonna save it both ways. So for now, go ahead and grab the whole thing. We'll see what the land impact is. 17, that's not bad. Let's make sure that the ball is fine. Friend, here it is. And there we go. Go ahead and name that. 17 land impact, that's not too bad. But I need to go ahead and link it. That's ready to go? Yep, it is. Alright, so there we go. That's my final roof. Not too bad. Only took about 20 minutes, maybe 25 minutes to make that. Now I know how to make it. It will take 10 minutes next time. Alright, so there we go. That's my Oriental roof for today. And now I need to build a structure for it. And of course, I'm going to go ahead and name this. We'll call it COS, or Cosmic Labs. That's the name of my building company. And we'll call it Oriental, make it easy to find, roof. Korean version 1.0. And I'm gonna go ahead and model that out. Give it a couple of different faces, and I'm gonna go ahead and mesh it. Use a program to mesh that out. Alright my friends, this is Dan Hacks. Hope you've enjoyed watching this quick little video on how to make an Oriental roof for your next build. Have a great day, have a great day, have a great night, and we'll catch you next time. I'm going to go ahead and record the rest of my build, so I'll probably upload that separately, and at which point you'll see how this roof is implemented into the final build of my new home. Have a great day, and a great night. Dan Hacks, out.